My name is Karen Perez. My topic is jugular vein. Definition: the jugular vein are in the neck and drain blood from the head, brain, face and neck and convey it toward the heart. Applications in medicine: the external jugular vein descends from the angle of the face to the center and collarbone, ends in subclavian vein. Drains blood from the mostly the skull and face. It is caused by the bending from the retromandibular vein and posterior auricular. Structure: there are two sets of the jugular vein, external and internal. Internal jugular veins are veins that bring desiccated blood from the head back to the heart via superior vena cava. External jugular vein receives the greater part of the blood from the exterior of the cranium and the depth parts of the face, being formed by the junction of the posterior division of the retromandibular vein with the posterior auricular vein. Advantage: jugular root has an advantage of being very useful. It is anticoagulated patient, and that removing the introducer vein hemostasis is obtained by gravity. Only place the patient in semi-sitting position. Another advantage of this approach is that in the case of hematoma may occur neck compress relatively easily. Disadvantage: it is not an easy access route in the case of obese patient with short neck, and the vein is more difficult to access, partly due to lower sharpness of the anatomic landmarks in this patient. What is the function of the internal jugular vein? The internal jugular vein function is to carry blood away from the interior of the skull and the deeper tissues in the neck. The internal jugular are actually bigger than the external ones. What is the function of the external jugular vein? The external jugular connect at the base of the throat with the internal jugular, through which the blood continues onto the heart. Diseases: the solid diffusion, thrombophlebitis, thrombosis, jugular injury.
Для выполнения катетеризации еремной вены голова пациента должна быть повернута в противоположную сторону. Шея слегка разогнута. Находит точку, расположенную в верхушке треугольника, образованного двумя головками грудино-ключично-сосцевидной мышцы. Пальпаторно определяет сонную артерию и смещает ее медиально. Иглу проводит в латеральные артерии под углом 30 градусов к поверхности шеи в направлении мамарного соска. При этом производится постоянная аспирация до идентификации вены. Шприц отсоединяют и через просвет иглы проводит гибкий проводник на 4-5 см за конец иглы. Иглу извлекают. Место пункции расширяется дилататором. По проводнику в вену устанавливают катетер. Проводник удаляют, повторно аспирируют кровь для контроля положения катетера. Подсоединяют инфузионную систему или заполняют катетер гепаринизированным раствором. Фиксирует катетер кожи лигатуры.
Then I know that I have something going on. Well, what can cause an increased jugular venous pressure? Well, the jugular vein can be distended by a right atrium buildup. So if the right atrium, the right ventricle cannot pump, then the right atrium will have an excess backup, and that will be reflected in the internal jugular, because that's going to be coming off off of that SEC. So that's why we test the internal jugular. It's because of its proximity and its relationship to the right atria. So this approximately gives us a picture to the right atria. Again,
this is the difference between an internal jugular vein and external jugular vein. This is the external jugular vein. It is engorged. But this is the internal jugular vein with the jugular venous distension all the way up to the ear. And that is a sign of wide open tricuspid regurg. So it is very important to tell the difference between the external jugular, which is engorged, and the internal jugular, right up to here.